Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, children of all ages, the Triangle Film Collective is back once again to kick off this most glorious of New Year's. But unfortunately, it starts off a little sad as Mr. Honeycombs himself is not here this week. He is on vacation and he will be sorely, sorely missed.
But wait, even though Honeycombs is on sabbatical and has left us far behind, we've got a special guest star, none other than Master P, our one and only Jeff's father-in-law, who has now decided to join us and give us his wisdom.
Yeah, most men in their late 60s don't like to be called Master P. That's usually reserved for rappers and criminals. But we go with it, and we let the man have what he wants. So we're going to be meeting up with him soon at a very, very special location, and we will see you there. And we have finally arrived in not-so-sunny Raleigh, North Carolina, here at the Roast Grill, home of hot wieners, and also the home of new friendships and togetherness, as you meet the one and only Master P, my father-in-law, the Silver Fox, the man that I've patterned my whole life behind.
First of all, Jeff, thanks for having me here, and I love being here with Sam. You know, I've known him for a long time, and we're going to have a great time here having some nice hot dogs, alias wieners.
Yeah, hot wieners.
Hot wieners for everyone.
At the famous Roasted Grill. As you can see, the decor is phenomenal, and we can't wait to get inside, but we're a little early.
Yeah, it's a real dump.
Yeah.
I'll tell you what I'll do. Sam, we've been friends for a long time.
Sure.
Why don't we flip, okay? And whoever loses the flip will buy the dogs for the three of us. How's that sound?
Okay, let's go for it.
All right, here we go. Just happen to have a coin on me.
All right.
You call it.
Heads.
Oh, you lost. You're gonna have to buy the hot dogs.
All right, just this one time. And then Jeff will pay me back later, I'm sure.
Yeah, that's a lie you'll choose to believe for some reason.
Okay, can we go in now?
Let's go.
And we have just arrived over here at the movie theater. Very excited to see Mark Wahlberg in The Gambler. Hoping that he can do just as good as he did in that well-acted masterpiece, The Transformers and Planet of the Apes. How are we feeling about this thing?
Well, I don't know about you guys. I, for one, was kind of hoping for something a little bit different. And by different, I mean anything that doesn't have Marky Mark in there, I'd be perfectly all right with.
Well, I gotta totally disagree. I'm pumped for this movie. Big fan of Mark Wahlberg.
Yeah, this was actually a compromise. We were going to go see Into the Woods, but three guys at a musical just didn't really resonate.
Oh, gosh. That would have been another wonderful review, I'm sure, about my lack of a love life and how I couldn't find a girl to go with me, so instead I show up with Sausage Fest. But, yeah, I guess this does seem better now compared to that.
Again, I'm really excited about seeing this John Goodman. Is that his name?
Goodman.
You know, I want to see if he's going to explode. It looks like he weighs around 500 pounds in the video clip that I saw. But I do have a problem.
Okay.
Did you see the prices?
Yeah, we missed the matinee time just a little bit.
Matinee time? In Rochester, I can go to the movies for a dollar on Tuesday. A dollar. You see the prices over here? Are you serious?
Well, I guess down south we have to charge you a little more, but don't worry about it, Master P. If you need a little help, I can cover you.
Hey, that's my man. That's what I was counting on.
There we go. That's what I'm here for, right, Jeff?
Yeah, that's what you're here
Thanks,
for.
Thanks, buddy. Thanks, Sam.
Is he gone?
Yeah, he went to the bathroom again. Third time in one trip. I've never seen that.
Listen, dude, I don't mind helping out. I don't mind being a good friend. But I just bought lunch for three, and now I'm buying movie tickets too. Like, enough's enough.
Well, yeah, like you said, though, we missed the matinee. What do you expect him to do? He doesn't have any money.
Listen, if I'm going to be shelling all this money, I mean, I at least need to be called something other than Sam.
Yeah, but you've been responding to Sam. That's kind of your own fault.
What am I supposed to do, man? He's your father-in-law. You need to...
Hey, come on. Hey. Ready, Sam? Let's go. Let's get some popcorn.
Why not? Why not?
Okay, thanks, Sam. Let's go get some popcorn now.
Great.
Hey, Sam, thanks for the ticket. I really appreciate it. Yeah, really appreciate this ticket.
Not a problem, Master P. Not a problem.
Well, did you get a senior citizen for yourself, though?
No, they don't give me that discount. I had to pay full price.
Oh, whoa. Give me your ticket. I'll go back. Let me get some. Hey, guys.
Hey.
How's it going?
Welcome back.
Forget something?
No.
I thought you were buying a popcorn.
Popcorn? I can't afford popcorn.
Don't you work? Don't you got a job?
I work hard.
I don't have any money. I'm retired.
Listen, I've been a good sport. I am going to enjoy this movie, despite the fact that Marky Mark's in it. But popcorn, just a little too far.
I got to be honest with you. I came up a little short today. I didn't bring that much money with me.
Well, it's good because you haven't had to spend any of it yet.
We are just out of seeing The Gambler, the movie that had a startlingly large lack of Kenny Rogers. So, gentlemen, what did we think?
Jeff, before we go any further, can I have a little discussion with you?
Yeah, what do you need?
Well, you know, when I came from Rochester, my back was bothering me.
Yeah, you mentioned that a lot.
And the seat back here is pretty cramped. Is there any chance me and Sam can switch?
Yeah, get out. Give me your seat.
Okay.
He's 70. Get out.
All right. 69. Can we talk for a sec first?
Yeah. So what's the problem?
Listen, Jeff, you are my friend. And I'd like to think I've been a sport about this, but...
Hey, Jeff.
Yeah?
This seat is much better, but are your seats heated? Can you put any heat on here?
We'll be right there. Just go ahead and roll the window up. We'll be right back.
Hey, another thing. Can we do this tomorrow? Can we... I'd like to try it again. I think we had a good time today.
You got it, big guy. You got it. Whatever you want.
All right.
Just go ahead and roll that window back up. We'll be right there. You were saying?
I don't know where to begin.
Get in the back seat. That's where you begin. Get in the back seat.
Dude, that's enough. I have paid for his lunch. I have paid for his movie ticket. I sat in the front. I gave up my seat.
The front is the best seats. You can't get any closer than that, buddy.
No, the front is where we had to sit because he couldn't see the screen. Then apparently the best seat in the house was mine, so I had to get up and move.
It was drafty there.
Yeah. Shit.
And we're back. I think everybody's a little happier where they are, right?
Oh, man. Phenomenal.
Yeah. All right. So we just saw The Gambler, which had Mark Wahlberg in it, which immediately was two strikes against it right there just by having Marky Mark in it. But just not my thing. Didn't really enjoy it. Didn't really get into it. What about you?
Loved it.
What was there to love about it?
Well, let me show you. Let's start with the story.
It had a story, yes.
I loved the story.
You brought props.
Oh, yes, I got props.
You brought props.
I thought it was a very good story about a guy who has a dark attitude towards life. He wanted to kill himself. It was dark, but all in all, I really loved it. Then,
he's got more.
The acting.
It's
I thought the acting was very good. I think Mark Wahlberg is a really well-rounded actor, and John Goodman...
That's John Goodman.
Goodman, yeah. Well, he was phenomenal. And is he in a peak of condition?
No, yeah, he's real fat. And bald and old.
The music.
Yeah, there was music.
I love the music. They had nice music of the 50s and 60s in there. It really set the tone of the whole picture. The length.
I thought the length was a little long, a little slow at times.
Yes, it was.
I think they could have probably knocked an hour off of it.
They probably could have.
But not a bad length. Was I entertained?
Yes, I was. I was entertained.
I was entertained watching that movie and just moving right along, waiting for it to end.
Yeah, well, we were all waiting for that.
Is it a hot ticket?
No, it's really not.
Do I recommend it for people? Absolutely not.
No.
Don't waste your money. Wait for Netflix or wait for direct television, pay-per-view, but don't go see it for... Mine was $7.25. Yours was $8. I feel sorry for you guys. You paid an extra 75 cents.
That's correct. Right. Correction, yours was $0.
By all means, don't waste your money on the ticket to go see this movie. Believe me.
Oh, Sam, I forgot, Sam. hey, thanks, Sam.
All right, Master P, we appreciate it. Whatever that was. Sam, what did you think of the movie?
It was a giant steaming pile of poo. It was way too long with way too little. The entire cast and crew could have been cut.
All of them, huh? He wants to cut an hour out of it, which wasn't even a two-hour movie, and want to get rid of the whole cast.
Yeah, you got to admit, John Goodman was good.
Oh, yeah, John Goodman was fantastic. He's the only one who took this seriously and had fun with it.
He showed up. Yes, he did.
The rest of the script is about a man causing himself problems and destroying everyone he loves. So here's a hint. Don't love Mark Wahlberg.
Yeah, it ends badly. I would say that this is a combination of Leaving Las Vegas and Rounders, yet not as good as either film.
One thing I can't stand about this movie is the entire premise of it is Mark Wahlberg blowing $500,000 just to sleep with this girl.
Are you sure there's just one thing you can't stand about this movie, or was there more?
This is the main thing. The main thing. But, you know, she's not A-list celebrity material. She's not supermodel pretty. She's barely girl next door.
She's frumpy.
And the whole deal is she wants to sleep with him anyway.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, he might as well just said, hey, let's go sleep together, and I'll just pocket this $500,000.
Can't argue with that, Sam.
Every conflict in this movie derives from that. The fact that he can't work up the nerve to say, hey, let's go out.
So on behalf of myself, the master himself, Master P, and Sam, we would like to thank you for tuning in, and hopefully Mr. Combs will be back next week.
Thanks, Sam, for showing up.
See you later.
Sam, can we go get something to eat now?
My name is Sean.
I thought it was Sam.